idea I want to take you on a short road trip.
Wow.
Welcome to my YouTube channel, Obed In The Wild. So today we're in the heartbeat of the Rift Valley, which is Nakuru, and definitely we want to check out a place where you can chill just for a few hours as you're within Nakuru and see the hidden gems and the beautiful things that are within Nakuru. Basically, Nakuru is a very, very beautiful place. So you guys hang in there and let's enjoy the wild world together. Really, actually, you see, most of the time they migrate from Lake Nakuru. There is a Lake Elementaita, so it depends with the season. So we're in Kenyatta Avenue. This is the main street in Nakuru. Yeah, but basically, this is Nakuru. You can see it's green. It's beautiful. Many years ago, it was voted among the cleanest city in East and Central Africa. So we are still regaining, we are coming back to where we were. So we want to go to Java, grab something to eat or drink, and then now we can start our journey. So guys, now we are leaving Westside Mall and we are heading to Egerton Castle. This is a castle of love and hate. Yeah, because it has a very interesting story which we are going to unfold as we head to Egerton Castle. So basically it's around, I think less than 5 kilometers away. So it's not far, within 30 minutes drive, we'll be there. So there are different ways you can use to go to Egerton Castle. So one, it's either you can drive yourself, what we are doing. And then secondly, you can take a matatu, which will charge you around 50 shillings from the town center. Once you alight the matatu, you have an option of walking, which is good, which is exercise, or you can take a motorbike, which will charge you around 50 shillings. So that is around $1 from Nakuru town to Egerton Castle. Or the third option, you can decide to walk from town to the castle.
It's also exercise.
As you mesmerize the story of love. The masks are now compulsory. You can't go anywhere without a mask. Back on the road. So in the next 30 minutes or less, we'll be in Egerton Castle, located in Ngata area.
Sky.
It's really awesome.
The view is just...
There are a lot of activities you can do in Nakuru, so this is one of the activities you can do in Nakuru when you have a weekend in Nakuru. This place is a must, it's a must visit. Egerton Castle. You can see, man, we have beautiful malls. Yeah, it's called the Golden Life Mall. Some awesome moral.
Egerton University, Lord Egerton Castle. And then Ngata Road, that is the castle road.
So here we are. So we are finally here, Lord Egerton. Come, and let's get to go the story of love.
Is that why you're in charge?
So with us here, we have our guide.
So I'm Mr. Victor Macau. I'm a tour guide at Lord Egerton Castle. I'll be taking my friends here around the castle, giving them the story, the information about the history of the castle and the man who built the castle by the name of Lord Maurice Egerton. So welcome to Lord Egerton Castle. This is the castle, and here we have the man by the name of Lord Maurice Egerton of Tartle, born in a place known as Shesha in Britain in the year 1875. So he was from a royal family in Britain. He had joined the British Royal Navy in 1895, and he was part of the men who took part in the First World War. In the First World War, he was played the role of a lieutenant in the Navy. In 1920, and on arrival in Kenya, he met another Lord Namea, the one at the Naivasha place. He had already settled in Kenya, who convinced Lord Maurice Egerton that around here, Nakuru place where we have Ngata, it's better for wheat farming than Timau. So Lord Namea convinced him and sold him this land. And initially, this land was 21,116 acres.
Wow.
Yeah, it is. So the land ran from where we have Midlands Hotel in Nakuru, a very old hotel on 1905 Ocean, all the way to Menengai Crater, to Kabarak, where we have our former president Moi's land, through Rongai and Bagon to Egerton University. So in that land was doing wheat farming. He decided to settle here. This was like the center of the East land. Here he built three houses. We have the first one, I'll show you later, built in 1920. It was a site house. So we have the second one, built in 1924. It was the actual cottage, built in 1924. It has six rooms, two bedrooms, a living room, a dining room, a kitchen, and a store. Then we have the third one, a castle, built for 16 years, from 1938-1954. The reasons why this one took that long to be built is because most of these building materials were imported. Like this is British oak, and an import from Britain, and the means of transporting this wood was water transport, which was totally slow. It would take between 6 to 8 months from Britain to Mombasa, then the railway from Mombasa to Nakuru, then the Africans would carry the wood to this place. And also the man himself was taking part in the Second World War between 1939 to 1945. So behind these three houses, we have another short story about him and someone, a fiancée, a lady, a princess from Austria. The name of that lady, she was Princess Victoria. So they had dated when they were in Europe. So when this man came to Kenya, he decided to invite that lady. So the first time the lady came to Kenya was in 1924. She found the first and second house. And since she was not a princess, she was not impressed. She said they were very small. and they were undermining her class as a princess. So this Lady Victoria told Lord Maurice Egerton that the first house looked like a bird's nest.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Then she said the second one looks like a dog's kennel.
Mm-hmm.
So this lady, so after the lady refused the first and second house, this man, Lord Maurice Egerton, decided to impress the lady with something royal, something big, something classy. He decided to build a castle.
Mm-hmm.
But now this one took 16 years to be built.
Yeah.
But still she was not impressed.
Yeah. With this one now,
yeah,
the one that we're in right
she
now.
She still said this one was also small.
Yeah.
She did not even set her foot inside this castle.
Yeah.
She only went around the house, the castle. Then she told this man that this one looked like her father's horse stable. So this man was, Lord Maurice Egerton was very mad, hurt. So to an extent of trying to shoot that lady, but he was controlled.
Yeah.
The lady managed to escape and left back to her husband in Europe.
Yeah.
Then Lord Maurice Egerton was left in Kenya, the devastated, heartbroken, everything, hurting, to an extent of hating women and banning them from his compound. He had also built the famous Egerton University, but then it was Egerton Farm College in 1839.
Yeah.
So he also banned ladies from that college.
Yeah.
So only men used to be, to study in that college. So when a lady was found anywhere within this place, she would be shot or whipped like a horse. Also, this man developed hatred towards birds, chicken, dogs. Because the way the lady referred the first house is a bird's nest, the second one is a dog's kennel.
Yeah.
So he stayed here for 4 years doing wheat farming and also other activities like building industries in Nakuru, like Nakuru blankets and Nakuru tama.
Yeah.
He died in 1958 at the age of 83 without a wife, without a kid. And this man, Maurice Egerton, was the only person remaining in that generation, the sole heir to the Egerton family, the crown and wealth. So when this man died, there was no anybody else to inherit. So that was the end of Egerton family. After his death, he was buried at the Nakuru cemetery.
Because they spit and kick.
Yeah. They spit like rhymes.
They can be eaten, milked.
Can you eat them?
They can be milked.
Actually, I'm feeling the wool is really.
They got like some dreadlocks going on here, like mine.
Okay, take it easy, bro. Guys, remember,
so,
every maze has one entrance and one exit.
Okay.
3 hours down the line. Interesting, man, you need to come down here.
Whoa.
Wow. Like birds in the air, we met out in the breeze, not knowing each other, but destiny had a plan. Like a cliff beautifying nature, you are really a treasure I found without mine, which is very hard to find. These are the exact words that the poor Baron of Egerton, Lord Maurice Egerton of Tarton, used to bring her presence down to Ngata. But unfortunately, the love story ended in a tragic way.